Hi, in this segment we will be talking about functions in C++. Now the basic structure of a function we actually looked at earlier when we talked about the main function. Okay, but we'll go back to that now. Now each function has a name, and there are inputs. Possible inputs, I should say, and possible outputs. And then there is the body. And if you do have an output, then you would return the output at the end of the function. Okay. So let's look at some examples of functions here in the code. Let's say I want a function that will calculate, for example, the area of a triangle. And so I would have an output, and it would be a double, which would be the area. I will name it triangle area. And I'd actually have two inputs that I would need. I would need the base, which is a double, and I need the height, which is also double. Notice I've separated the inputs with a comma. And notice that I've given a name to the inputs, but the output doesn't have a name, okay? It will know, C++ knows the value I want to output because at the end of my function I will again say return whatever value I want it to return. Notice with this format I can only return one output, okay? I have my curly braces, which define the body of the function, and as we talked about before, it also defines the scope of any variables that I define within the function itself, okay? So I will create a double, a real number area, and the value of area is 1/2. I could do 0.5 or I could do 1 dot divided by 2. Remember to put the decimal, otherwise 1 divided by 2 will give me 0, right? So watch out for that. So I'll make that 1 point divided by 2, base times height, okay? And then I just return area. Okay, so now I'll go down into the main function, and I will print that to screen. Actually, I'll create a double here, area. Notice I've declared area twice. I have a double area here in my main function, and I have a double area within my triangle area function. But again, they're both within their own respective scopes, so it's okay. They don't see each other. All right. I've created a double area there. I'll say area is equal to triangle area, and I'll put in, just for an example, 2 as the base and 3 as the height. And I will print that to screen. So we can see what it gives us. Okay, my source code is saved, and so I will make run. And it prints to screen 3. 1/2 the base, which is 2 times the height, which is 3. Okay, gives us 3. All right, we can actually save some space in this function. Instead of creating a double area, defining what the value of area is in the function, and then returning the value of area, I can do that all within one line. If I want to, simply say return 1/2 base times height. And if we run that, again, you see it gives us the same value of 3. Now, looking back here at the top, I'm passing in values for base and height. You could consider these as being read-only values, read-only inputs, you could say. What's actually happening is in the function, I'm copying the values of my inputs, base and height, and using that within the function to perform some calculation. Okay, There is another way, that's actually called passing by value, and passing in the value of the variable, but not the variable itself. I can't modify base and height outside of the function itself. However, sometimes it's nice to be able to do that. For example, if you have multiple outputs that you want, then you can pass in an input by reference, which allows you to change that input, and you can change multiple inputs at the same time. So let me create another function here to demonstrate that, what passing by reference involves. So here, instead of returning a double, I'm not going to return anything, so I'll put void. And I'll pass in double base, double height. Both of those I'll still keep as read-only. But I will also pass in a double area. And I'll pass that by value. Remember from our discussion on pointers that the ampersand refers to the address or the reference of a variable. Okay, so I'm passing this in by reference. And so instead of saying return 1/2 base times height, I'll just say area equals 1/2 base times height. Okay? And now the value of that input has actually changed within the main function itself. And now instead of saying area equals triangle area, I also need to change the function name. So I'll call the first one triangle area 1, this one's triangle area 2. So for triangle area 2, I'll still pass in 2 and 3 for base and height, but I'll also pass in a double area. And notice I haven't set anything equal to triangle area because that function is void, it won't return anything. But it will modify the value of area that I'm passing in. Okay, so now I can run that. And I still get the same value of 3. Okay, now what if, I mentioned before you might want multiple outputs. So what if, for example, for a square, I just want some generic information. I want to pass in this length, but I want to get out of it both the area and the perimeter. You notice I couldn't do this as easily. I mean, I could maybe do as an output a vector of doubles, and the first component of the vector could be the area, the second component of the output could be the perimeter. So that would be one way. This is another way to do it, which I think is a little bit cleaner. Okay, and so here I would say that the area is equal to length times length, and the perimeter is equal to 4 times length. Okay, so now I need a double perimeter. Now notice just to make a point, I'll change these names here. They don't have to be the same. My inputs within main don't have to have the same variable name as what's defined in my function inputs, okay? So I'll change these names just to make that point. So I will input those into square info. I'll pass in a length of 3, for example, pass in area 1, and perimeter 1. And print those to screen for us to see. Okay, so my file is saved, and so I can run it. And it gives me an error here because I misspelled length. So these error statements are really helpful. And usually they can tell you exactly where you need to go, where the mistake is in your code. Okay, so now that is saved. And it looks like I also misspelled perimeter there. There. Okay. Now we'll run it again. All right, 9 and 12. So 3 times 3 is 9, and 3 times 4 is 12, giving us the area and the perimeter. So that's an example of what you might use a function for. Now here, my functions have all been numerical, but remember, functions in C++ aren't necessarily a mathematical function. So let's say I could create a function that would print a vector, the components of a vector, to my screen. And it would be a void. And I will just call it print vector, or print vec. And I'll take as an input a standard vector of doubles. And I'll call it output, or out. All right. And then within this function, I just want to do a for loop for int I equals 0, I less than out dot size, I plus plus. And then I would then print to the screen out component I standard end line. Okay, so that would be an example of a function that's not a mathematical statement. It's just something to make the main body of my function a little bit cleaner, or the body of my main function to be a little cleaner. So down here, if I have a vector declared, a vector of doubles, you're going to notice in this case, because the input to my function is a vector of doubles, it won't work on a vector of ints, for example. And I'll do length 3, components 1.2. Okay, and now I just call this function print vec. I input, uses an input test. And as I run it, there you can see it. Use the function to print all the components of the vector. Okay, so that is just to show you that a function doesn't have to be a mathematical statement. We use functions usually to make the body of the main function a little bit cleaner, a little bit easier to read. And often, if there's something that you're repeatedly doing within your body, you probably want to make a function so that you've only defined the operation once and you can just refer to it again and again. Okay, so that will conclude our discussion on functions, and in the next segment, we'll move on to talking about classes.